I want you to know, Mr. Cooper, that you were just named E.T.'s Hottest Bachelor of the Year.
Really?
By our online voters. Did you know that?
No, I did not know that.
Your mom.
It's going to be... I'm sure my mother already knows that. Or she voted for
she
all of them.
She cast a lot of votes.
She went That's around so funny and lobbied you know the neighborhood well. To cast the votes, right?
I'm sure she did. Thank you, Mom.
You two are speaking of very sweet, two passengers on an airliner who get to know one another in this movie. But you, in actuality, had gotten to know each other quite well a couple of years ago by performing together on stage.
Just very well, perfectly
yeah.
well. I mean, you know, when you, basically, if you cross the desert with someone yeah. and survive.
That's what
then,
it's akin to.
Yeah, you're friends
yeah,
forever.
Yeah, we were in war together, yeah.
Yeah.
We had both never done a play.
Yes.
And let alone a Broadway play.
Yeah.
Called 3 Days of Rain, which is what we did.
Right.
And it was, I lost 17 pounds during rehearsal.
Cut to this movie. Did you have a choice then of the roles so that you guys could work together again?
Well, I did it. I mean, when I found out she was, that was the main reason. And Gary Marshall. Yeah, that was the reason.
So if I have to pin you down, was it Julia who really was the pull, or was it Gary?
Well, I mean, all my stuff was with Julia, so it was, yeah. Both, though, yeah. you know. Yeah.
But, had fun but you didn't have to kiss Gary.
I didn't. I did not.
Even though the roles aren't that big in this movie, getting together with friends again has to be something you look forward to and makes it special.
Well, you know, to be with Gary, and Gary and I realize that we do this every 10 years now. This is our third movie, and they're 10 years apart. Each one.
Oh, that's
yeah.
neat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm guaranteed work at 51. But to be with him, and then we had a lot of our crew from Pretty Woman, and, you know, it was like old home week. It's astonishing. This time goes by and you can still find that same camaraderie and you're laughing at the same jokes.
Julia has a lot of experience. Have you looked to her for some advice along, you know,
towing the A-list line?
Yeah, her advice is awful. For me, nothing's really changed in terms of having more opportunity. I mean, The Hangover was just a movie that was seen by a lot of people. So it's just, you know, more opportunity to do great work.
But I have to speak for Bradley because I know his parents. He comes from a really solid family. He knows who he is, and I think that that's the best thing you can have going for you in this business is you know who you are when you start, and so those external things don't alter you. You know, whether it be someone seeing a movie that you were in or, you know, somebody thinking that you're the hottest whatever, you're still who you are.
Yeah, that's true.
Julia, did you see The Hangover last summer?
I did, and I hate movies like that.
Yes.
But honestly, I thought it was so incredibly funny. Incredibly funny.
It was so much fun.
I got dragged.
By Danny?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Dragged.
You had to see it. Well, so the question is, and everybody wants to know this, are you doing Hangover 2? When does it start?
We are doing Hangover 2, yeah.
Is it called Still Hungover?
Maybe. I'm going to pitch that. I'm going to pitch that.
How do you keep the romance going? You have to make time to still have romance in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys do that? Do you work at it?
So far, it's still coming rather effortlessly to us.
Yay.
Yeah. But you've seen my husband.
I was just going to say, I like to answer that question for her.
Do you have plans for Valentine's Day? Do you like it? Do you hate it?
Come over to the Motors.
Okay,
I'll
yeah.
make a nice cherry pie. In my heart-shaped pie pan.
Perfect.
Well, see, you can have a lot of fun with Valentine's Day because of the kids.
Yes, but we have to sit down and make, like, 55 Valentines for all their classmates.
Yes.